వందేహం శ్రీగురు శ్రీయుత పదకమలం. Should be in the reading matter. Otherwise, there will be no end of question and answer if you bring all the matter. Yeah. Anyway, you can finish it. Yes, any question? Some of them are eternal associates, some of them are promoted to that eternal association. Suppose if you go and become an associate playmates of Krishna, so your position also become now eternal. If simply the eternal associates of Krishna can play with him, not others, then what is the meaning of your becoming Krishna conscious? You can become also. How? That by past deeds of many, many lives, you can also become promoted to that position. Kritapunna punya. Actually, in the home of Vrindavan, in this material world, the Vrindavan, mostly the associates of Krishna are these conditioned living entities who are promoted to that Krishna conscious perfection stage. They are first of all allowed to see Krishna in the planet where Krishna's pastimes is going on. And then they are promoted to the transcendental Vrindavan. Therefore it is said in the Bhagavad, Kritapunna Punya, they are all promoted. But even though are promoted, they are now eternal associates. Is it clear? Hare Krishna. So, any other question?
Is it possible for one to engage himself in bhakti yoga without rendering service to Krishna? Let's say somebody who
without Krishna, where is bhakti?
Well, someone who's worshipping Lord Buddha.
That is not bhakti yoga. Bhakti yoga is simply in connection with this Krishna. Bhakti yoga cannot be applied in anything else. And how Buddha philosophy can be dovetailed with bhakti yoga? Bhakti yoga means to understand God. Bhaktyama vijana, he'll find in the Bhagavad Gita. 15th chapter. By bhakti yoga, you can understand Lord, the Supreme Lord, God. But in Buddha philosophy, there is no God. That you know? So where is bhakti yoga?
In the case of Christian, someone worships Jesus Christ.
That is bhakti yoga, because they accept God. Unless you accept God, There is no question of bhakti yoga. So Christian religion is also Vaishnavism, because they accept God. Maybe in the some stage, different from this, there are different stages of God realization also. The Christian religion says God is great. Accept. That is very good. But God, how great God is, that you can understand from Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. But there is acceptance that God is great. That is, therefore, that is beginning of bhakti. You can apply that bhakti. Even in Mahamadan religion, that is also bhakti yoga. Any religion where God is the target, that can be applied in bhakti. But when there is no God, or impersonalism, there is no question of bhakti yoga. Bhakti yoga means bhajadatukti, bhajasivaya, service. Service means three things. The servitor, the served, and service. One must be present who will accept service. And one must be present to render service. And in the bhaya media, the process of service. So bhakti yoga means service. If there is nobody to accept the service, then where is the bhakti yoga? So any philosophy or religious principle where there is no acceptance of God, the Supreme, there is no application of bhakti.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.